So this is the scene of a film that the general Kim Jong-il directed.
Yes, he likes the film very much.
The first thing you realize is this isn't a film studio, it's a museum. No one's making any films here. It's yet another shrine to this guy.
혁명영화 피바다 창작 사업을 현재 쓰지도 하시는 위대한 용도자 김정일 동지 있습니다. 1969년 8월 29일 날 이 칸도 토벌 장면을 현지에서 지도해 주셨습니다. 여기 집을 56개 지어놓고 이렇게 불을 지키면서 촬영을 합니다. 경리하는 장군님께서는 이 촬영기 하나 가지고 오모니 손만 찍다 나면은 옆에 장치물들이 불에 타서 다 없어지게 될 것이라고 하시면서 이렇게 속대를 동세 이용해서 촬영을 할 때에 대한 가르치심 주셨습니다. 그래서 원래 이 촬영기 하나 가지고 이 장면을 이틀 동안 찍기로 계획돼 있었는데 위대한 장군님께서 속대를 동세 이용하도록 하셨기 때문에 8시간 동안에 완성해냈습니다.
So, the North Koreans believe that he invented the whole concept of multi-camera shoots in 1964. In fact, they believe he's so great at making films that they made a film about how great he is at making films.
Visiting the filming hall, he taught the cameraman and actors how to shoot and act. This resulted in the creation of masterpieces that teach man the truth of life and destiny.
And my favorite thing is, if you're a little unsure as to what exactly Kim Jong-il did on this film, what was his role, there's a list.
여기 주요지도 일지에서 보시는 바와 같이 위대한 장군님께서는 1964년 4월부터 2003년 4월까지 11,890여 차례를 쳐서 지도를 주셨고 구중 현지 지도만 1,770 차례를 쳐서 주셨습니다.
So he gave on the spot guidance how many times?
여기 촬영소에만 350여 차례를 쳐서 나오셨습니다.
Yes, 350, more than 350 times.
He came here 350 yeah. times, but he gave 11,000
phone calls?
아니, 1,770 장면 현지 지도 말이에요.
아니, 야들 이거는 저기서 내가 이야기하지 않았습니까? 64년 4월부터 2003년 4월까지 총효 지도가 1,890여 차례고 이사 이 손님이 나고 촬영실 몇 번 나오셨나? 그래서 여기는
알겠습니다.
350 차례 나오셨다. 아. 이거는 문화예술부문 전반에 대한 지도란 말입니다.
아니 그게 아니고 아 이거 그게 아니고 지금 이거 숫자가 있는데 이거 물어보자.
아 이건 날짜라기죠. 이건
아니, 날짜.
이건 2003년 2월 10날 아니나 이 숫자가 들어갔는데.
We've got it now. The general Kim Jong-il came here 350 times. He gave 1,770 directions, but also 11,890 guidances. And these are all of the those things categorized here. I'm not going to ask what 8941 is because when I asked what the 11,890 was, it caused quite a stir. It's kind of like 20th Century Fox or something.
They took us rapidly from room to room to room. Some rooms we could shoot, some rooms we couldn't. I don't know why. We could shoot the camera room, but we couldn't shoot the Soviet mixing board.
No more shooting?
From this moment.
From this moment, okay.
이렇게 현지에 나오셔서 지내셨습니다.
General Kim Jong-il gave the sport guidance to for changing
the
walls.
They've got recreations of their
which
meals that they used to eat.
President Kim Il-sung
filming
wrote in 1930s.
You covered the camera.
I've not told you.
Can you break them off?
He himself saw this guitar.
He played the guitar.
No, the actors and actresses use this guitar.
He saw the guitar.
He saw this guitar.
He was giving on-the-spot guidance with this camera, and they kept this camera here. Can I look?
Yes, you can.
Thank you. So I'm looking into the same camera that the General Kim Jong-il looked through. I can see things. I can see marvelous things. So this is kind of like their equivalent of, you know, the Wild West town, and they'll have like the saloon and whatever. This is their equivalent to make Asian history films. And do they have a like a Japanese or American street or?
There is the Chinese street, the Japanese street, and European street, and also the, our mountainous street.
Can we see a European street?
They are repairing now.
Repairing.
If they see, they are disliking. To see you.
They don't want to see
us. Yeah, they want to see you.
Okay.
Because this is okay. Sorry, sorry. We should go.
We have to go?
We should go.
They're now kicking us out for some reason. We asked to see the European street and the American street, which they blow up when they blow up America, but they won't let us see it. And now we have to go quickly. But we're on the film set in the Pyongyang studio.
When we finally got into the film studios in North Korea, I expected to be taken to a sound stage or see people filming, making movies, but we just got another museum. It was a facade. And like the Arirang Games, it's just a show. And you realize they're doing all of this for the dear leader. It's Nero. As Rome is burning, we need the spectacle. The DMZ, the People's Library, the Juche Ideals, the Arirang Games. It's just a bunch of sound and fury that signifies nothing.
Only victory and glory are in store for the Workers' Party of Korea. Long live the 60th anniversary of the Workers' Party of Korea.